It is a very good afternoon and welcome to this week's edition of AMH Conversations. My name is Rumpa Diving, and as always, this is your think tank show that allows us to delve into all the pertinent issues affecting Zimbabwe's discourse. And as always, we've been talking about the upcoming budget statement to be handed down by the Finance Minister, Professor Thuli Ncube, this afternoon. And in studio today, I'm joined by a panel of guests just to assist us to delve into what are the things that we can expect from the budget, what areas have been historically left uncharted, and really, what can we expect? And I'd like to welcome to the studio Mr. Tinashe Kadua, who's an economist. Good afternoon. Welcome, Tinashe.
Thank you, Rumpi. Good afternoon.
And I'm also happy to welcome Vandu Zaizireba, who's an economist with Buy Zimbabwe. Good afternoon and welcome.
Thank you, Rumbi. How are you?
Very it's well, thank you. Here. Excellent. And lastly, but certainly not least, we want to welcome Mr. Tumai Mafunga, who is the head of Assurance Zimbabwe and a chartered accountant as well. Good afternoon and welcome.
Good afternoon. Thank you.
Excellent. So, Tinashe, I'll throw you straight into the deep end. The 2009 budget, unpacking that. From your standpoint, obviously, we've received the fiscal measures earlier in the year. We also saw the transitional stabilization program being doled out by the finance minister. Juxtaposing against that, what can we expect from the 2019 budget? And what areas, really, are you expecting as an economist to be covered by the upcoming budget?
Okay, thank you, Rumpi. This 2019 national budget is the first budget under the transitional stabilization program. Mm-hmm. So I expect it to be an implementation of the transitional stabilization program. If you look at the policy framework that the finance minister pronounced together with the pre-budget strategy paper, mm-hmm. We anticipate the finance minister to implement some austerity measures and also at the same time balancing it with economic growth. Mm-hmm. So I foresee this coming budget as a balancing factor between maintaining a higher growth as well as reducing fiscal deficit. Mm-hmm. That's one of the areas that I foresee the finance minister focusing more on. It's high time the country should really implement serious austerity measures, mm-hmm. and also enforce accountability, transparency, and accountability of budget. We should divert from the past tendencies where the government will propose a $4 billion budget, but the actual outturn will come up as $9 billion. Mm-hmm. That will derail all the essence of budgeting. Mm-hmm. So I foresee more responsibility and accountability from the finance minister.
Okay, interesting. Then we jump straight to you and say, what are your expectations?
Thank you very much. I think from maybe taking from 2009 where we dollarized the economy going forth, what I'm looking at and what we are looking at, maybe a bit of background, where I'm representing Buy Zimbabwe, where we are advocating for production and consumption of local goods and services. Mm-hmm. I understand that one of the key issues that we should see and what we are keen and eager to see is export promotion and improvement of domestic production. That is, obviously, we are looking at foreign currency shortages and cash shortages as our major challenges, one of the major challenges. And as Buy Zimbabwe, we are saying that if we don't promote exports, where we can highly get the foreign currency that is needed, then it means that our budget, again, it will be looking at trade deficit. We are looking at more imports that vis-a-vis the export that we are producing. So in a nutshell, I'm looking at a budget that is going to be more export-oriented, mm-hmm. and local production. Mm-hmm. Again, is the background that obviously we want to look at a consistent budget, mm-hmm. where we are saying that if we allocate monies, wherever we are allocating monies, maybe to social amenities, we're looking at to have a budget that is consistent over the year to say that how is it so different from the prior budget. We're actually looking at if we could have a cash budgeting system, mm-hmm. where we then say we eat what we kill. If we don't have those monies, we mean that we prioritize the sectors that are critical, that is our agriculture, our mining sector, our education and health.
Mm-hmm.
That is what we are looking, that are the dynamics really that we are looking at.
Mm.
That maybe the minister will go back to the grassroots and address the pertinent issues that are affecting the local industry.
We hope he doesn't surprise us too much. Then we come to you, Timai. Why, you know, from your standpoint?
I suppose from my perspective, what I believe is quite critical is for that budget to restore confidence.
Mm-hmm.
from a market perspective. I won't dwell too much. I think that the matters of government expenditure have come to the fore.
Mm-hmm.
And where there is excessive deficit that goes to recurring expenditure, it always is a worry.
Mm-hmm.
And you have seen obviously what has happened with the prices. I am expecting that the minister will rein that in,
mm-hmm.
in whatever form, manage the level of, in consultation with the monetary authorities, obviously manage the level of liquidity that is playing out in the market.
Mm-hmm.
I am also hoping to see an allocation towards more productive sectors, just to, you know, reiterate what she mentioned earlier. And we've got to be very deliberate around where do our strengths lie,
mm-hmm.
and ensure that we are putting money into those particular areas. Beyond that, reallocations, I think health is
mm-hmm.
a big area for us.
Mm-hmm.
Education, I do believe while we may have had a strong education system, I think the world has moved on, and we need to be able to be investing more money into our education systems to allow for us to produce people who can respond to the needs of Zimbabwe for tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
The issue of currency, I think, is obviously another issue of debate. What currency are
mm-hmm.
we operating in?
Mm-hmm.
Is it US dollars?
Mm-hmm.
Is it RTGS? Because that is what is also making us not so competitive in certain factors.
Mm-hmm.
I was sharing earlier on with a colleague that I had a visitor from Germany, and we were in Victoria Falls, and there was a bottle of wine, which naturally in any other economy should cost you about $50 US,
mm-hmm.
and this bottle was going for 150, and that's a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And so you will find people gravitating to Zambia, should they need be. But that's just an example
mm-hmm.
of what happens when the economy is distorted.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Indeed. Gentlemen, he raises a very critical issue. Currency.
Yeah.
What are we using? Do you feel that this is a factor that should be addressed in the budget? Or it will simply carry on as it was going on, which really is no good for anyone. So, I mean, it's been said, and I was looking at the former finance minister's tweets a little bit earlier, and he said one of the major issues will be determining what currency we're using,
mm-hmm.
and then determining an exchange rate, because obviously this 1-to-1 parity has become a farce, and it's not happening in practice.
Mm-hmm.
I'm one of those persons who believe that currency issues are secondary. I don't see it as a primary thing that the government should address.
Okay.
If the government fixes its fiscal space
mm-hmm.
and instill fiscal discipline and restore fiscal credibility,
mm.
then all those monetary issues will sort out themselves.
Mm.
Whatever currency which we may introduce and whatever monetary form which we introduce, as long as the government expenditure pattern is not curtailed, it means that currency will always come under pressure.
Mm.
If you look at our economy, we have to accept that we are now a consumption-driven economy rather than a production-driven economy.
Mm.
For us now, there is need of a shift and a very good clear policy that will take us through to a certain currency framework that we may want to follow.
Mm.
With bond notes, the RBZ governor tried to, you know, to de-dollarize the economy
mm-hmm.
by introducing bond notes.
Mm-hmm.
We have seen there are so many countries that have tried to go that same way. The likes of Argentina, it
mm-hmm.
tried that same way, but it failed.
Mm-hmm.
So the problem that happened in Zimbabwe is through that bond note,
mm-hmm.
people were forced to convert their US dollars to a local form of currency.
Mm-hmm.
at a ratio of 1:1, which is not market-driven. Mm-hmm. So we want proper market-driven policies that are supported by a proper long-term policy framework, which will be implemented through these budgets.
Mm-hmm.
So I foresee this this coming budget as one of the first or critical interventions by the mm-hmm. finance minister
mm-hmm.
to restore sanity in the economy.
Mm-hmm.
So the current, yes, it's a serious issue in the economy, but I see it as a manifestation of deeper lying fiscal imbalances in the economy,
mm-hmm.
which the finance minister should address.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so Tinashe says it's symptomatic. Currency is not really an issue.
Yeah, no.
It's more about the systems and the frameworks, and even if we had a Zula dollar, it would
yeah.
still not work. What are your thoughts on that, Wandaza?
Obviously, I somehow agree with it,
mm-hmm.
that the current manifestations that we are seeing, it's really about the symptoms,
mm-hmm.
and that's not the cause.
Mm-hmm.
We're looking at 2009
mm-hmm.
and to debt.
Mm.
And if we remove the years that that has transpired when we're using the multi-current system, I think we just gone back again to the issue where we're questioning whether we should adopt the rand, whether we
mm-hmm.
should adopt the yen, whether we could use the US currency.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously the issue is really to say that the US dollar that we're looking at, and it's a foreign reserve,
mm-hmm.
and it is never used as day-to-day currency that we should.
Mm-hmm.
We should accumulate US dollars so that we reserve them
mm-hmm.
for critical, maybe critical sectors of
mm-hmm.
the economy.
Mm-hmm.
So really the issue of currency as we stand right now, I'm comfortable that the minister has his consultations to come up with the most optimum currency that we should be using. But obviously, if we can even go back to the US, even if we adopt the rand, if the fundamentals are not right, as Tinashe has exactly alluded to, I don't think we still have 10 years and we come back again to the same discussion that which currency should we should be using. So in a nutshell, or the fundamentals that I think they should be addressed, to say that let's look at the import bill.
Mm-hmm.
What are the issues that the major products that we are importing using our hard-earned US dollar?
Mm-hmm.
Because tobacco and the minerals are the only they are the maybe about 60% or more from tobacco and minerals, gold, platinum, and those are the, we are taking that money to go and buy probably toothpicks, match boxes,
lace chips.
So if we really want to deal with this world currency issue,
mm-hmm.
let's look at the fundamentals.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see where is our US dollar going to,
mm-hmm.
and what is it exactly. Obviously, if you're using your hard-earned US dollar to fund a recurrent expenditure, then exactly there is a challenge.
Mm-hmm.
If we could use our US dollars that we have now to do capital expenditure and maybe revive the infrastructure,
mm-hmm.
revive certain industries, which we think we have got case studies like the dairy. The dairy
mm-hmm.
now we can safely say we are meeting some of our domestic demand, because there was a deliberate effort to resuscitate the dairy
mm-hmm.
sector. So we should be looking at the sectors that we can revive.
Mm-hmm.
So we look maybe at soya, at wheat, at even all the cereals, to say
mm-hmm.
that if we address the import bill, we're saying that it's about 2 billion every month where we are importing cereals.
Shocking figures. So to my just before we go for the break, I'd like you to maybe just also speak to that issue, and
mm-hmm.
maybe also address the splitting now of the foreign currency account and the RTGS account as
right.
well. If I could just get your comments on that, and then we'll go for a quick break.
All right. I think I largely agree that the issue of foreign currency and the rates is probably may not be a priority at this stage.
Mm-hmm.
I think there are significant value loss factors that
mm-hmm.
need to be considered, but there has to be a journey to resolving the excesses that are there. I am quite encouraged by the splitting of the RTGS and the the USD or Nostro FCA, if
mm-hmm.
one would call it that, because I think what was happening, it becomes very difficult for exporters and also as a country in certain cases to measure reliably how much we are generating. And I do believe that users of that particular foreign currency or who have generated that foreign currency have got to at least have some access to that foreign currency without any inhibitions.
Mm-hmm.
The whole process of having to go back, put in applications, I think would create its own challenges. It's interesting, and kudos maybe to the Minister of Mines, where they had reduced the allocation, I think down to 30%. And immediately you saw a significant reduction in gold deliveries that were happening with the miners, artisanal miners as well.
Mm.
And when they've increased it to 55% now, it will be interesting to see what happens in the months to follow.
Mm.
So I think as a way, it is maybe a tacit confirmation that maybe these currencies are not
there's no parity there
at this stage. Uh-huh. But I think it is a good move that provides for accountability.
Indeed. Well, on that note, we take a quick commercial break. Please do stay tuned for another segment of AMH Conversations.